time to chow down with the Juicy Dolls. Please welcome your host, Vanessa Jasey.
First mukbang video. I'm your host, Vanessa Jasey, and this is my co-host, Miss A.
Hey.
Boy, tell them a little something about yourself, Miss A.
Well, I do have a podcast called My Lovely Lunatic Leo Life, and I also love to do karaoke. I'm actually a karaoke queen. Actually, it's hip-hop or trap karaoke. And I love to travel, and I love to eat. I'm a flats kind of girl.
Oh, yeah?
I like the flats.
And I like the drumsticks.
There we go.
Now, we're going to tell you guys how we met. Miss A and I used to work for Wendy Williams. We used to intern for her many, many moons ago, from 2007. When did you come in? You was there before me.
Yeah, it must have been 2006 or 2005.
Okay, and I came in like 2006 to 2007. I can't. So that's how we met there, and it was an interesting experience. One day I was walking through the hallways, and Wendy.
We can eat while we talk, right?
Well, oh, that's right.
Girl, we're supposed to be eating. Oh,
we're supposed to be eating and talking.
Oh, yes. Okay. Food is calling my name.
Okay, we're getting ready to eat. And, well, we just want to talk about now, really quick, the reason why we started this, because we want to, of course, we enjoy eating. We really believe this form of broadcasting started on the Wendy Williams show, because in 2007, I'm going to claim this, 2007, Wendy Williams used to have me eating on air. And Yeah, I don't like beer. And I used to be belching all over the place.
I can't.
Smacking all over the place. I'm about, this is good.
And I was in the intern room like, damn, why can't I be up there with Vanessa and Wendy? Mad as hell.
But that part I had fun on, going on air every Thursday and Friday, just, you know, eating. People like, oh, you're not embarrassed. And I'm like, nah, we creating feelings. I get it. You know, I was a little older than the other interns, so I get what she was doing. And but not only that, she did put me on LA Weight Loss later for free. So that was dope.
So I was trying to line it up, like one line flats, one line drums, but it was like, I couldn't.
That hurt. That skin up against my roof and my mouth.
That cold chicken.
But I just want to give you the meaning of mukbang really quick. It says mukbang is a live online audiovisual broadcast in which a host eats food while interacting with their audience, usually done through a webcast. Mukbang became popular in South Korea in 2010. Like I said, I don't think this is true. It started in 2007 with Vanessa the intern right on the Wendy Williams show. And Miss A was also the intern at that time. So not only can she vouch for me, but I actually have proof. So we're just going back to our roots. So with that being said,
yes,
finally eating.
Yo, y'all don't know what we went through to get this food today. Okay, like it was a lot going on.
You ain't lying about that.
So we finally getting it together.
Got to get your vegetables in.
This chicken right here, and it's so messed up. I was craving chicken last night, so I was like, I'm gonna get Chinese food from the Chinese store, forgetting about fried chicken today.
Wow.
So this is my second time having fried chicken today, and I don't eat fried chicken like that. I swear I don't. Hungry hippo. But
well,
this a lot.
Well, we're actually still celebrating the Super Bowl, even though we didn't watch it. So we're, you know, having our own Super Bowl Monday right here at the Juicy Dolls Dollhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yesterday, well, we got these things on our face because we are taking our Super Bowl Sunday into Super Bowl Monday here at the Juicy Dolls Dollhouse. So that's why we have these black marks. We know nothing about football.
We sure don't.
She got on a football jersey. I don't even like football. All I did was make sure to watch the halftime part, because I'm sure people that don't like football probably tuned into that part. Did you see it, Miss A?
No, I missed it. I didn't even watch it at all. I was like asleep half the day yesterday.
Who won? The Cowboys?
No. Last thing I make.
That's a shame. This supposed to be stretchy cheese, but because cold. We waited forever. Shit, cold as hell.
Everything's cold as hell. No, it was the Kansas City Chiefs versus the 49ers, and the Kansas City Chiefs won, in the last... They were losing until the fourth quarter.
How do you know if you didn't watch it?
No, because I saw a Facebook post, and it said, at third quarter, then you saw the 49ers take, a group picture, mm-hmm. and then in the fourth quarter, they're, sitting there with their hands in their heads and shit.
Oh, so, wow. Like I said, all I watched was the halftime. I felt that they racial profiled the performance because, you know, we all love J-Lo and we all love Shakira, but they do know there's a lot of Spanish descent down and that live in the Miami area. So true. I feel that was racial profiling.
You know, some people actually were kind of annoyed that they weren't Miami natives. Mm-hmm. So I guess if they were from Miami... It wouldn't have been so much profiling, but...
Well, when the Giants had their Super Bowl at the Meadowlands, wasn't there... at the Meadowlands, right? Or am I wrong?
Girl, I don't know, okay?
I'm sure if they ever had the Super Bowl here at the Meadowlands in New Jersey, they probably didn't get no New Jersey artists. Person. They didn't call Queen Latifah. They didn't call
right.
Naughty by Nature. You know, they probably called somebody else. I don't think they have to be a native to...
No. But, you know, people are upset about me. Imagine, people are mad that they were dancing in their outfits, which they look amazing, by
the way. Yes, J-Lo looks great for 50. I want that body.
Oh, we didn't cheers.
To our first mukbang.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. But one other thing I wanted to touch bases on, they were picking on Beyonce and Jay-Z for not standing up during the national anthem during Demi Lovato's performance.
They need to kick rocks.
But there were other people that were sitting down of different races, and why are they picking on Jay-Z, Blue Ivy, and Beyonce?
Because they're celebrities. They got mad at her when she didn't stand up when Joaquin Phoenix got his award at the Grammy. Emmys.
Yeah,
one of those things. Like, no matter what they do, people are going to be upset over nothing. So, mm-hmm. F them.
Yeah. Boy. Mm-hmm. So, we have some chicken wings from Red's Bistro restaurant in Orange. What sauce is which?
I like that one is the honey garlic.
You like it?
Mm-hmm. The red one is buffalo. Mm-hmm. And the other one is the Thai chili.
Mm-hmm. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the plates? We forgot to put plates.
You have plates?
No. Actually, yes, I do.
Mm-hmm. We got napkins.
They're in the back. But we're going to use napkins for now. Mm-hmm. Mm. So... Do you have a boyfriend, Miss A?
No.
Do you want a boyfriend?
I want a husband, girl. I'm tired of being single. I've been single for so long.
Mm-hmm.
I've been dating, though, here and there, but I don't even date that much either. But I just don't understand because I feel like I'm such a dope person.
Mm-hmm.
I love to have fun. I love to travel.
Where have you been?
I've been to Mexico, Cayman Islands 4 times, Jamaica, Bahamas. I just did a solo trip to Thailand by myself. It was amazing. That shit was so fucking dope. Mm-hmm. I went to New Orleans by myself. That was my first solo trip.
Mm-hmm.
But it definitely didn't compare to going to Thailand by myself. Where else? I've been to Ghana.
You had like a tour guide?
Mm-mm. I just booked everything in advance. So I looked up shit to do. Mm-hmm. I swam with elephants. I fed them. I bathed them. I did a motorbike tour going up a mountain.
Mm-hmm.
I've only done motorbiking in Miami. You know you can rent the motorpeds or mopeds.
Yeah.
And so I was confident enough to do it. And that was still scary because you're really going up a mountain in another country where cars are going to pass by you in order. Like, it's 2 lanes, one each way. So they got to wait till nobody come around. It was kind of scary sometimes. Then I was like, yo, what if a tiger started chasing us and I'm going up the hill? And
so they run free like that there?
Yeah, I don't know. I saw a video and there was Asians in the forest on a bike and I saw a lion just come out. It was a video I saw a long time ago. I don't know where it happened, but that's all I was thinking about.
Wow.
But other than that, it was amazing. I did a Thai cooking class. It was great. It was just great. But I'm trying to go to Ghana next year. No, December.
That's my birthday. December 1st.
I'm going to the end of December. But what are you going to do for your birthday? Well, you have a bad time. Do you have plans?
Well, hopefully this year my boyfriend will take me out. I mean, take me out of here.
Out of the country?
Yeah.
That'll be nice. Vacation and
yeah,
birthday.
Vacation. Yeah, bay birthday.
When's his birthday?
His birthday is July 27th. So he's a... I'm sorry, July 25th. He's a Leo. You're a Leo?
Yeah. I'm July 23rd. The first day is the best day.
Yep, he's a Leo.
Leo, and you're a... Sag. That's a good... That's a very good... Mix.
I believe it because my cousin is Leo and me and him are like best friends. My first cousin.
I was dating someone who's a Sag. I thought we were great, but
care for the sauce too much.
Which one?
The buffalo. The buffalo?
What about the Thai chili?
That's good.
The and garlic then, one just tastes like barbecue sauce.
Where's the garlic one?
It's the brown one.
No, it's not. That's the Hennessy.
Oh, I thought we told her garlic. Remember we kept changing it?
Yeah, but they only gave us three.
Okay. Oh.
Or maybe it is a garlic. I could be wrong.
It's good, though.
And nachos. I would, but I'm not.
What you mean you're not?
No.
Eating this?
I'm eating it.
Oh.
I'm not promoting.
Oh.
That place.
Okay.
Because you're not smaller. Yeah.
Say less.
Boy.
My number 13 was also kind of to commemorate Kobe. Because 1 plus 3 equals 4, and 4 times 8 is 24.
4 times 8 is not 24, that's
32. Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
Oh my God, you're right. That's good.
Boy.
So that's why I got my little 13. If that makes sense.
It makes sense. But it only makes sense for you.
Yeah.
I understand what you're saying, but nobody is gonna just look at that and be like, "Oh, that's for Kobe." I don't get it.
No, I don't either. Never mind. Moving on. All right. Maybe I should try these veggies.
Oh, man, my ranch veggie dip.
Oh, what? Oh. I love tomatoes.
Gotta get your veggies in. Damn it. I'm getting full.
Already?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shoot. Never left a shoot thing. Oh, sorry. But I'm always, by the time I finish cooking my main meal, I'm too tired to cook the rest of the vegetables, so that's terrible, right?
Yeah.
Maybe I should start the veggies first and just let it sit.
Damn, I don't know if y'all can hear, like, those sirens in the background, but we're in Maplewood, and it's literally, like, 5 cop cars just went down. They probably went down towards Wawa, because that Wawa right there.
Really?
Yeah, it's always, because it's, like, the border of Irvington.
Oh, shit.
So, it's always some action going on down there. That's probably the most action they ever get. In Maplewood.
I'm actually kind of mad I had chicken this morning or this afternoon.
For lunch?
It was my second fried chicken today. I have 4 pieces.
Oh my God.
And I don't normally eat fried chicken, but I was craving it and I forgot about it. I should have just waited. Who does that? And have lunch to bring to work. You ever bring lunch to work, but then you ate it for dinner the night before, so you don't want it because you know it's dinner at home still? Leftovers? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Why did you leave Wendy Williams' show?
I was fired. Well,
I was fired, too.
Technically, she didn't fire me. She told Taryn and Nicole that she was over me to let me go softly.
That's her. I believe it.
So I was just like, thank you. So I told her, okay, it's time for me to go. Thank you for having me. Like, I don't know if that was a whole plan.
You said you told her that.
No. Wait, what?
That you told her that it was time for you to go? That's what Nicole... No, that's Nicole, what they told
she told Nicole and them that she was over me. She was ready for me to go. But it happened because of a beef at the club with my friend. Kevin's friend tried to holler at my friend.
Uh-huh.
And she was not having this ugly-ass Jamaican dude. Little as hell. She gave me that look. You know when your girlfriend's like, all right, try to take me away or I'm over it? So I was like, all right, come with me to the bathroom. And he got mad. He's like, hold, you don't see me talking to her? And his Jamaican accent. I'm like, yeah, but we got to go. So when Kevin came, he was talking shit. So the next day, that's when Wendy said, she's over me. It's time for me to go. So, can we talk about the impeachment or not?
Yeah, if you want.
I don't really want to talk about it. I just want to acknowledge that this shit is happening for this motherfucker. Because I'm so sick and tired of his bullshit. That's all.
Yeah, but... Oh, they said the Senate is full of Republicans, so that's the most important vote. So he'll probably win.
But I feel like it's all a circus anyway. Like,
it is.
None of shit matters. Mm. Does it? Really?
I just don't want them to blow us up.
Me neither. They should just come for him. Just for Trump? No, seriously, like... They went... let me shut up.
What?
Trump went after their leader. They should just go after him. They put an $80 million bounty on his head.
I heard.
But that. You know what that bounty really was?
What?
They said if all the Iranian people put a dollar together, then they would do it. They weren't saying they'll pay literally with their government money. They're saying the citizens put the money together. I guess they didn't want to be liable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So they were smart.
You're not big or juicy.
I'm juicy, right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all that juice was delaying me from going up the damn mountain. And just to say that my job, Fast Science, we did do a banner, and we put it outside for people to sign, and surprise, it got more than we expected. We had to actually make a second banner for the weekend, and it was filled up on Saturday. The first one was like 3 feet by 20 feet. The second one was 3 feet by 10 feet.
Wow.
And it was filled with signatures. So we thank you. We sent it out today to Staples
to
Center.
To where? Okay.
On Channel 12 News, too.
I saw that.
Yes.
Congratulations. I'm mad that I didn't get a chance to sign it. I was hoping to do that today, but I do remember in the news clip, it said that Monday you guys were going to ship it out. Mm-hmm. We all know Kobe Bryant just passed about a week ago, and everybody loved Kobe Bryant. I never got a chance to meet him. I was hoping he would be one of the people I get to meet, but unfortunately that didn't happen. So we want to do a moment of silence for Mr. Kobe Bryant and Gigi and all the other people that was on the on that helicopter. And I'm going to pour a little bit out for Kobe.
Wait. Oh.
We'll pour a little bit out for Kobe.
Okay.
And... let's do a moment of silence. Let's give Kobe Bryant a moment of silence, please. Okay. We love you, Kobe.
We love you.